little teeny tiny pieces. Apparently that is, this is what the president apparently has a habit of doing to documents inside the White House, documents that need to be preserved, documents that we're now being told need to be taped back together by staffers, everything from memos and notes and letters and even negative news articles he just doesn't like. He rips them up. But the problem is, those are all official records that need to be kept intact. With me now, the writer who broke this story, Politico's Annie Carney. And Annie, I'm not such a great ripper, but, you know, it's the Presidential Records Act. The White House has to preserve all of this stuff that the president touches. Does Trump not know that?
He has been told that by aides who have noticed his habit and tried to stop it. And that warning didn't have any effect on his behavior. He's continued to do it. And so instead of trying to get the message through again, basically his aides are cleaning up after him. They're taking the waste paper basket or the paper that's tossed on the floor from the residence and from the Oval, and they are bringing it over to the records management team, who are then scotch taping it back together and sending it over to the National
Archives. Hold on a second, because I was reading about these two workers, one of whom was a career government official close to 30 years under his belt. And so they would be tasked to buy this particular kind of clear scotch tape, right, so you could see the words. Mm-hmm. And they would spend their days scotch taping back together.
Yes, Go and on. They said that sometimes, you know, it would just be one big rip down the middle, and sometimes it would be like confetti. And they ended up seeing really this work as a type of punishment. These guys earn like $60,000-$70,000 a year. They take some pride in the job they do. They consider themselves, you know, civil servants, and they're coming in here to do really a menial task. And they were astounded that this is what they were asked to do every day. Under the Trump administration, they said they've never seen anything like this in any other administration. Yeah.
And I read you said, you know, Obama was more of a preservationist, right? He was constantly thinking, oh, this speech and this and that, and I need to be, you know, this needs to go to the archives. And obviously it's the reverse for President Trump. Is this something, do we know, has he done this for years? Is it anything he reads?
It's basically, like, aides described to me as kind of his unofficial filing system. It's just like, okay, I've taken care of this paper. I don't need it anymore. Rip it up, throw it out. That's what he gets rid of stuff. And, you know, I mean, that's maybe fine if that's how he did worked at Trump Org. If it worked for him, great. But he doesn't have any preservationist instincts here, and he doesn't seem to have an eye or an understanding of the history and of the importance that really any document that comes across the Oval or that he writes on, even if it's not important, if it's just a letter from a kid who met him at a rally, is a presidential record, and that needs to be stored. And his aides have tried to explain this to him, but it just doesn't register, or he doesn't care, it seems to be the case.
I just want to quote one of these guys quickly here, because they got walked out of the White House by Secret Service. When she walked me out and took my badge and the gate closed behind me, it was like, damn, that's 20 years of White House service gone. Some nights I cried and I was mad because I got comfortable. One of the words from Solomon Lardy here as he was walked out by the Secret Service. Annie Carney on the notes and the memos that the president rips up. Thank you so much, Annie,
for
that. Live pictures out of Singapore today as the president and Kim Jong-un get ready to meet face-to-face. We will show you around Kim's luxurious hotel, plus the Secretary of State using a key phrase that could tell us everything about what may come out of this summit. Stand by. This is CNN special live coverage.